当我回国服侍的时候呢，一提到精炼，大家都会想到一位上帝重用的仆人，就是宋尚杰。
So each time I return to my hometown China to minister, when I talk about Jinlian, my hometown people would remember John Song.
我们知道三十年代的时候，宋博士呢，他带领整个的中国，甚至在东南亚，有教会的复兴。
So in the 1930s, Dr. John Song has led a great revival not just in Southeast Asia but also in China.
那么他是二十三岁的时候就拿到了美国博士这个。化学博士的这样的一个金钥匙奖。
So therefore, when he was 23 years old, Dr. John Song received a PhD in chemistry and received a gold key for that award as well.
但是他却为了传福音，把这个象征荣誉的金钥匙丢在了大海的里面。
Now, but for the sake of the gospel, in order to continue the further of the work of the gospel, he threw away the gold key in recognition of his work on earth.
他讲道传福音大有能力。
And after that, he continued to preach with fervor and with power.
他责备罪恶，很多人流泪悔改。
And during those days, he rebuked sin, and many repented in tears.
但是当他四十四岁的时候呢，却得了很重的病。
However, at 44 years old, he had a very great affliction.
当他死的时候，非常的痛苦。
And when he died in pain.
当这样的事情发生的时候
Now when such a thing happened
很多的人会问一句话
And many people may ask this question
神的仆人做工如此的有果效
If the servant of God he was so effective in his ministry
为什么上帝不多留他二十年呢
Why didn't God allow him 20 more years to continue serving
为什么神所重用的仆人上帝会许可这样的苦难发生在他的身上呢
Why would God allow such a suffering to happen to a man that served the Lord faithfully?
是的，我想在一些流行成功神学的教会的里面，不会讲到苦难。
Now I believe in many churches that propagate prosperity gospel, they will not talk about suffering in church.
信徒的生命当中没有苦难。
To them, suffering does not exist in believers.
我信耶稣要的就是成功顺利。
And to them, being a Christian means I must be rich, I must be healthy, I must be smooth going.
苦难呢，把它藏起来。
So suffering, I must hide it where no one can see it.
所以，如果你病得医治了，可以上台来做见证。
So therefore, do these churches, if your sickness were healed, you'll be allowed to the pulpit to testify about it.
死了呢，最好不要知道。
But if you die, then hopefully no one will know about it.
所以教会就是报喜不报忧。
So therefore, to such churches, to them, success, happiness are more important than others.
讲台所讲的就是今天好，明天好，天天都很好。
And the messages of the pulpits are today is good, tomorrow is good, every time it is good.
可是亲爱的弟兄姐妹，刚才当我们打开圣经哥林多后书。这段圣经所讲的。
But yet, dear brethren, when we turn to the scripture in 2 Corinthians chapter 1, the message that we have read about it,
你会发现圣经并没有给我们描述一个乌托邦的美好世界。
Now you will discover that 2 Corinthians does not describe a world that is perfect.
主耶稣也告诉我们说，在这个世界上你们是有苦难的。
The Lord Jesus also reminded us that in this world you will have troubles.
你们是要劳苦担重担的。
That you must bear the burdens of the cross.
但同时，主耶稣也告诉我们。
But yet at the same time, Jesus also said to us.
世上你们有苦难，但是在我的里面你们有平安。
Oh yes, in this world you will have troubles, but in me you will have peace.
劳苦担重担的人到我这里就可以得安息。
And all those who are heavy, laden, and burdened may come to me and you will find rest.
是的，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，苦难我们都不愿意遇到。
So dear brethren, we do not want to encounter sufferings.
但是苦难却有它的意义。
But yet sufferings do have their significance.
当我们说苦难是一个危机的时候
Now when we say that sufferings is like a crisis,
我们看危机就是在危险的里面隐藏着机会
And often in crisis, there will often be opportunities that avail us.
所以刚才我们所读过的哥林多后书一章三到十一节
So earlier we read 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 3 to 10
保罗在一开始的时候就讲到在他整个服事的过程当中遇到的艰难和苦难。
So right from the start, Paul related the many sufferings and difficulties that he had encountered.
保罗是耶稣基督的使徒。
Now Paul was the apostle of Jesus Christ.
但是他却没有逃避苦难。
But yet he did not escape difficulties and sufferings that come to him.
而同时也给我们看到。
Yet at the same time, we also discover
每一个神的儿女苦难都有它的意义。
That every child of God, each suffering that happens to us has its meaning.
特别是当你胜过苦难的时候。
Especially when you are able to overcome your sufferings.
就成为你生命提升的一个机会。
You become an opportunity that you will grow in your life.
而我们要看如何胜过苦难的危机呢？
And today we must see how can we overcome this crisis of facing such difficulties.
从这段圣经的里面我们看到，首先你要承认苦难的存在。
Now from this passage we must know that first of all, we must acknowledge the existence of suffering.
苦难的存在是很真实的。
For suffering does exist.
是没有答案的。
It does not provide an answer.
而且可能会随时的发生。
And it may happen to us anytime.
我们知道哥林多后书是保罗在服事的第二个十年所写的。
Now we know that 2 Corinthians was written by Paul when he was serving in the second 10 years.
那哥林多教会是保罗在第二次旅行布道的时候。
So it was the second missionary journey of Paul.
他听到马其顿的呼声。
When he heard the call of Macedonia.
他就过到腓立比。
And then he went to Philippi,
建立了腓立比教会,
and then started the Philippian church.
然后到帖撒罗尼迦,
later on, he went to Thessalonica,
比利亚,
to Berea,
雅典,
in Athens,
后来来到哥林多,
and now later to Corinth.
那哥林多呢,是一个繁华的大都市。
Now Corinth is like a cosmopolitan city like today.
同时也是一个敬拜偶像的地方。
So it was also a city that worshipped idols.
可以想象在这样的一个地方传福音布道是举步维艰很艰难的。
Can you imagine how difficult in those days to preach the gospel to evangelize in such a city like that?
好像在今天的新加坡和中国的一些的大都市也是一样。
Now it is like Singapore and the major cities in China as well.
那我们看到当保罗他在信主之前他是学历很高的人。
Now Paul was highly learned before he became a Christian.
有很好的社会地位。
So he has also high prestige and status.
在仕途上他可以说是平步青云。
Now in a secular world, he was outstanding and a bright future.
但是自从被主选召以后。
But the moment when the Lord had called him,
他成为外邦人的使徒。
He became an apostle to the Gentiles.
而在他的人生当中就充满了艰难。
And from then onwards, his life was filled with difficulties and sufferings.
他传的是让人得救的福音啊。
And the gospel he preached then was a gospel that can save men.
但为什么却有如此多的苦难在他的身上？
But why did he experience so much difficulties and in his life?
当我们读使徒行传的时候，
Now when you study the Acts of the Apostles,
我们看到保罗面临许多的逼害，
You will discover the hardships and the persecutions that Paul faced.
政治的势力，
Political troubles,
同族犹太人的逼害，
And also the Jewish opposition,
还有人的暴力，很多很多的苦难在他的身上，
And the violence of the city men that were always upon him and his band.
所以当我们看到哥林多后书第一章八节这里讲到，
So therefore, you turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 1.
保罗说我力不能胜啊。
And here says that I Paul,
第八节，
in verse 8, sorry,
对， 被压太重，力不能胜。
He says that we were under great pressure far beyond our ability to endure.
我们知道保罗是一个很刚强的人。
Now we know Paul was a very strong man.
但是他在这个地方呢，表现出来的却是如此的软弱。
But yet when he said these words, it also showed his moments of weakness.
他说我靠自己的力量胜不过去了。
He says according to my ability, there's no way we can overcome.
他说我连活命的指望都绝了。
He said that even we despair even of life.
不单单是活命，连指望都没了。
Not only of living, he had lost hope as well.
可以想象一个人如果失去了盼望，
Can you
这是多么大的苦难。
Can you imagine if a person is in despair, it would be a great difficulty.
那我们要问了，
Now we need to ask ourselves.
他不是在服侍上帝吗？
Didn't he was serving the Lord?
为什么上帝不特别的眷顾他呢？
Why didn't Lord show great concern for his servant?
所以很多的人会问一句话说，如果有上帝，为什么会有那么多的苦难存在呢？
So many people often ask this question, if there is God, why would he allow such great sufferings in this world?
如果神是爱，就不应该有苦难。
If God is love, there shouldn't be any suffering in this world.
当然，我们基督徒最厉害的答案就是因为人犯罪了。
But our Christians, our most outstanding answer would be because we men have sinned.
所以，凡是受苦的，就一定是犯罪的。
So therefore, all we that suffer is because we have sinned.
因为有罪才有苦。
Because there is sin in this world, so there is suffering.
所以为什么你撞车啊？
So therefore, sometimes we have an accident.
为什么你生病啊？
Sometimes we got sick.
因为你犯罪。
Because we have sinned.
当然，是的，有一些的罪呢，的确是因为人犯罪带来的。
Yes, it is true that sometimes bad things happen because man had sinned.
但我们要问的，难道苦难只是负面和消极的吗？
But we need to ask the other question, will sufferings always be negative?
有苦难的存在就是没有上帝吗？
Does it mean that when there is suffering, it must mean that God does not exist?
其实亲爱的弟兄姐妹，我们仔细想一想。
Actually, dear brothers and sisters, let us consider.
在我们现实的经验当中，痛苦和快乐并不是相对立的。
Now, in our everyday life, practically, in our goodness, and even things that do not come our way, they do not contradict each other sometimes.
我们知道女人要经过生产的痛苦就会迎来新生命的快乐。
Like for example, a woman must go through the difficulties of labor before she can receive the joy of having a newborn.
当学生呢，你要经过苦读才会迎来有优异成绩的快乐。
Or like a student, that he or she must suffer and labor in his studies before he can reap the joy of having good results.
所以只有你吃过苦才知道什么是甜。
Only when we have gone through suffering, then we will taste what is good after that.
所以有一位英国的文学家，他曾经说过这样的一句话。
So therefore there was once an English poet who once said this.
他说我相信上帝正如我相信太阳一样。
He says, I believe in God like how I would believe in the sun.
什么意思呢？
What does that mean?
就是没有阳光的对比，你不知道黑暗是黑暗。
Because if there is no darkness, you will never know the greatness of having light.
那这是因为有上帝美善的存在。
Because God's goodness exists.
你才知道什么是苦难。
Then we will understand what suffering is.
所以苦难的存在不会否定上帝的存在。
So therefore there is no paradox between what is suffering and the goodness of God.
是的，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，当我们纵观人类历史的时候，
So dear brothers and sisters, when we consider the history of mankind,
可以说是一部苦难的历史。
We may say it is a history of sufferings.
苦难是真实存在的。
For hardships do exist.
所以如果有人告诉你啊，他有什么样的秘诀，
So if somebody were to tell you I have such a secret,
有什么样的法术，
That I have such a method,
可以帮助你逃避苦难，
That can help you to escape your suffering,
帮助你趋吉避凶，
That you do not have to face any suffering,
叫做苦难的免疫法，
That this is a method to escape or to be immune to suffering,
千万不要相信，这都是谎言。
Please do not believe such fallacies.
因为圣经很清楚地告诉我们说，
Because the Bible tells us so clearly,
人为妇人所生，日子短小，多有患难。
That we men that are born of women, our lives are short and our lives are filled with strife and troubles.
所以当我们看到保罗在这个地方，他并没有掩饰为福音受福音所受的患难。
So therefore, when you look at 2 Corinthians, Paul didn't conceal, he didn't hide away the sufferings that gospel may bring to us.
他说，弟兄们，我们不要你们不晓得，在第八节，弟兄们，我们不要你们不晓得。
So verse 8, Paul says, we do not want you brothers to be uninformed.
就是保罗要让人知道的。
That is, Paul wants everyone to know.
我们从前在亚细亚遭遇的苦难。
About the hardships we suffer in a province of Asia.
保罗没有说信耶稣好啊，一定一帆风顺的。
Paul didn't say we as Christians are so good there are no sufferings at all.
而服侍神的人好啊，一定寿终正寝的。
That we serve the Lord is so good, we will enjoy all blessings.
没有。
No, he didn't say this.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹。
So dear brethren,
你如何胜过苦难的危机
？How can we first overcome this danger of suffering?
不要逃避苦难存在的问题。
Do not escape.This question about the existence of suffering.
不要想说拜一好，拜二好，拜三好，信靠耶稣天天好。
Do not always think that as Christian, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, every day is good.
我们要面对现实，肯定苦难的存在是很真实的。
We must face reality and the trueness that sufferings do exist.
而且你要接受苦难的存在是没有答案的。
And we must accept that the existence of sufferings will not provide an answer to why we are suffering.
当一个人受苦的时候，他一定问两个问题。
Because when a person suffers, he often asks these two questions.
一个是为什么？
One is why.
第二个为什么是我？
And why me?
信主之后，当我们有了圣经的知识呢，我们也试图的用圣经神学的知识来去解释苦难。
And often when we become a Christian, we know the Bible better. We often use theology in the Bible to try to explain sufferings.
但有的时候我们一定要坦白的承认。
But many times we must face on what is suffering.
神啊，我是愚拙的。
We can only say, Oh God, we are foolish.
真的无法测透你作为的奇妙。
We will never comprehend the marvels of what you have done in my life.
所以当我们看到保罗他在哥林多后书讲到苦难的时候
，So therefore, when we turn back to the sufferings that Paul was talking about in 2 Corinthians,
他并没有解释苦难发生的原因。
He did not explain why these sufferings happened to them.
而讲到的更多的是安慰。
But he spoke even more the comfort that he received.
是的，弟兄姐妹，当你面对苦难，如果你尝试去解释的时候
，So dear brothers and sisters, when you face sufferings and you try to explain away why you suffer,
可能会偏离上帝的心意。
A lot of times you may deviate from the will of God.
好像约伯的三个朋友
，It's just like the three friends of Job.
他们用人的逻辑来设计了一个天平。
They try to use human logic to try to establish a scale of life.
天平的这边，如果你放上善行、义行上去的话
，It means on one end, if you have a lot of credits to your life,
那天平的另外一端一定出现的就是祝福和安乐。
Then the other side of the scale will have a lot of blessings to balance your life.
而这边如果你放上的是罪恶和败坏的话呢
？And to them, in that scale, if you put evilness on one end,
那天平的另外一端一定出现的就是苦难和惩罚。
Then the other scale will have calamities, punishments to balance your life.
所以约伯啊，你为什么受苦啊
？So using this logic, they said to Job, "Why are you suffering now, Job? Do you know why?"
因为你犯罪了。
Because you must have sinned.
他们好像给上帝的公义找到一个理性的基础。
To these friends, they hope to find a human logic to explain away the will of God.
但是当上帝显现的时候，却责备他们说。
But when God revealed to them, this is what he rebuked them.
谁用无知的言语使我的旨意暧昧不明呢
？Who use useless words to understand and explain my will?
所以，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，不懂。就是不懂。
So dear brothers and sisters, a lot of times we do not understand means we do not understand.
承认我们内心的困惑。
We must understand this vanity, this foolishness in us.
人的有限。
That we are limited.
因为的确苦难的存在有的时候是没有答案的。
Well, it is true, a lot of times when we suffer, there is no answer to why.
好像义人为什么会受苦呢？
Just like the righteous people, why would they still suffer?
恶人为什么会兴起呢？
Why would so many wicked people they triumph and they rise?
无辜的孩子为什么会受到欺压和伤害？
Why are there so many innocents that suffer that go through hardships?
在上一个周，有一位姐妹马上怀孕，马上就要生孩子了。
So last week, I know of a sister who was pregnant and was about to give birth very soon.
结果医生误诊，最后她的脾脏破裂。
Suddenly, the doctor gave a wrong diagnosis.And caused a rupture in her womb.
母亲和腹中的胎儿全部都死了。
And both mother and the unborn child died.
留下丈夫和七岁的女儿。
A 7-year-old daughter and the husband survived.
而且医院拒绝任何的赔偿。
And the hospital rejected all sorts of compensation to the family.
七岁的女儿写了一张的字条。
And this seven-year-old daughter wrote this note.
妈妈，我知道你去了天堂。
Mama, I know you have gone to heaven.
那是美好的地方。
That is a beautiful place.
但是我真的很想念你。
But yet I miss you so much.
想吃你做的饭。
And I wish that I could eat your dinner again.
每个看到的人都流下眼泪。
Everyone who read their notes all shed tears.
我们要问为什么。
And we often ask why.
他不是上帝的儿女吗？
Isn't this family a family that belongs to God?
为什么生活当中有那么多不幸的事情发生呢？
Why would such misfortune happen to a family that belongs to God?
是的，弟兄姐妹，生活当中许多的事情，我们没有答案。
It is true we have no answers to many things that happen us.
而很多的人就是因为这些问题得不到解答，他拒绝相信耶稣。
And many people, because they have no answers, they choose to reject Jesus because of that.
其实，亲爱的朋友
，But dear friends,
当你接受人的智慧和能力是非常有限的。
When you acknowledge that the wisdom of men and the logic of men are so limited,
世上很多的事情都会释怀了。
And you will know that a lot of things in this world you can take comfort.
因为我们的小脑袋真的没有办法完全的明白所有的事情。
Because you must understand that our little wisdom cannot comprehend these things of the world.
就好像荣耀伟大的神的儿子来到这个世界上。
Like for example, how can anyone comprehend that the Son of God may descend from glory into this place?
为什么会降生在冰冷简陋的马槽呢？
And why would the Son of God be born in a cold, dark manger?
他要为人的罪死啊。
That he must die for the sins of men.
死就好了，为什么一定要死在羞辱的十字架上？
If he were to die, that's all right. But why must he be crucified such a cruel and shameful end?
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，这一切我们没有答案。
My dear brothers and sisters, we have no answer to these as well.
但是我们也不是消极的接受，好像宿命论一样。
But it doesn't mean that we just take this as a fatalistic way of life.
我们说，这就是命吧。
For example, we often say this is just the fate, my destiny, that's all.
虽然苦难没有答案。
Yes, sufferings may not provide an answer to why.
好像约伯到最后他也没有得到这个答案。
Like even Job, right to the end, he has no answer to his suffering.
但是约伯却教导我们一样的功课，就是恩典神学。
But Job has taught us an important theology, the theology of grace.
所以约伯说：“我是赤身出于母胎，也必要赤身归回。”
So Job once said that naked I come to this earth, one day naked I must depart.
赏赐的是耶和华，收取的也是耶和华，耶和华的名。是应当称颂的。
For the Lord takes, the Lord gives, but the name of the Lord must be praised.
是的，弟兄姐妹，我们来到这个世界上，没有一样的东西是属于你自己的。
Yes, brothers and sisters, when we come to this world, there is nothing actually that belongs to us.
一切都是上帝的恩典。
All things we must know is the grace of God.
上帝有主权给。
God has a sovereignty to give.
他也有主权收回。
He also has the same sovereignty to take.
一切都是天经地义。
Because everything is reasonable, all things belong to God.
而为什么你失去的时候会痛苦呢？
But why, when you lose, you will be in pain?
很多的时候你忘记这一切是神的。
Many times we have forgotten because all that we have actually belongs to God.
当我们把一切据为己有的时候，
When we self-possess these things as if they belong to us.
我的屋子，我的车子，我的孩子。
This is my car. This is my house. This is my children.
我的位置，我的票子。
This is my seat and this is my place.
所以当你失去一样的时候，你痛苦。
So therefore, one of it you lose it to you, it becomes a pain.
你失去两样的时候更痛苦。
You lose two, you'll be even more painful.
在我所服侍的黄岛教会。
Now in this Huangdao Church that I ministered.
有一位姐妹，她今年45岁。
So there was this sister, she is 45 years old today.
她在这些年几乎是与癌症共舞啊。
And all these years she lived with a cancer.
她患三种的癌症。
She had three three types of cancers.
从乳腺癌到子宫癌，现在是胃癌。
From ovarian to breast and now to gastric.
她动了四次的大手术。
She had four major surgeries.
每次手术之后的化疗非常的痛苦。
And after surgery, the post-surgical chemo will be very, very difficult for her.
但是上帝给她力量，她非常的喜乐。
But God gives this woman strength. She is often filled with joy.
她说上帝爱我啊。
She often say that God loves me.
不但切除了我身体上的毒瘤
，Not only he takes away the tumors of my in my life，
更重要的是切除了我生命中的毒瘤。
But more importantly, he takes away the evil, sinful tumor of my life。
他现在仍然坚持在教会的里面侍奉。
She continued to serve and minister in church。
我们的教会每天早晨五点钟有晨更的祷告。
Now every Sunday morning at 5 a.m. we have an early morning prayer。
她来带领。
She will be the leader of this prayer.
还有探访、传福音。
Also visitations, evangelizing.
她没有一样漏掉的。
There is not a single ministry she is not involved.
她说我不知道我还能活多久。
She said to us, I do not know how long do I still have to live.
还有多少服侍主的机会。
How many more opportunities do I still left?
她说但是我知道我活着的每一分钟都是上帝的恩典。
And she said, this I know,that every minute of my life that I live, it is the grace from God.
是的，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，如何得胜苦难的危机？
Indeed, brothers and sisters, how can we overcome this danger of suffering?
坦白地承认，苦难是真实存在的。
Firstly, acknowledge that suffering do exist in our life.
而且不要试图，必须找出苦难存在的答案。
And do not try to find an answer why you are suffering.
而且还有一个很重要的。
And also thirdly, something more very important.
你要预备苦难随时的发生。
We must prepare that suffering can strike us anytime.
我们看保罗在这段的圣经当中，不单单讲到自己所受的苦难。
Let us look at this passage. Not only did Paul mention about his own sufferings.
而且在第四节，他说，我们能用神所赐安慰，去安慰那遭受各样患难的人。
Verse 4, Paul also said,Who comforts us in all our troubles so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves have received from God.
第六节说，这安慰能叫你们忍受我们所受的那样苦楚。
So verse 6, Paul says, It is for your comfort that we are distressed, that if we are comforted, it is for your comfort as well.
这里哥林多信徒呢，还没有遭遇到患难。
Now here the Corinthian believers have not gone through sufferings.
但是保罗却教导他们你们要预备苦难的来到。
But first, Paul taught them before sufferings happen, prepare for sufferings.
弟兄姐妹，我想问你，你有预备苦难的到来吗？
So, brothers and sisters, may I ask you, have you prepared for sufferings that may come to you?
当你有预备的时候，苦难来，你就不会吃惊。
If you are prepared, when suffering suddenly strike, you will not be astonished.
其实活在世界上每天都有苦难的发生。
Actually, when we live in this world, every day may be a day that suffering may come.
我们知道前不久在印尼的两个礼拜堂被恐怖分子自杀式的炸弹袭击。
So we know that 2 weeks ago, two churches in Indonesia was bombed by suicide bombers.
你会想到吗？我们来做礼拜。
Have you ever imagined maybe one day when we come to church?
我们预备什么？
What are we preparing?
你说我预备奉献。
You may say, I come here to prepare to offer.
我预备领受上帝的话语。
I come to church to prepare to receive the teachings of the word.
我预备接受上帝的赐福。
I'm here to prepare that how God is going to bless me.
有谁说我要预备来接受炸弹的？
Who may say that I come to church to prepare to be bombed?
我想没有。
I believe none.
今天当我们要搭乘飞机去到另外的一个地方出差或者是旅游。
And even when we take an airplane, whether for a business trip or whether for vacation,
你会预备很多东西。
You may prepare for a lot of things for this.
但请问有谁预备过说我搭乘的这架飞机会失联？
Has anybody take a plane and prepare himself saying that my plane may disappear or may fall anytime?
或者是我搭乘的这架飞机，我预备了它的引擎会爆炸。
Or I take this plane and prepare myself that yes, one of the engine may rupture.
弟兄姐妹，我们不会这样预备的。
Now we will never prepare ourselves for these things.
但是如果我们很天真的认为说苦难不会发生在我的身上
But if we foolishly think that sufferings will never happen to me
当苦难发生的时候你会接受不了
Such that when sufferings do happen you can't take it
所以在彼得前书四章十二节彼得告诉我们说
So 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 12 this is what Peter said to us
亲爱的弟兄啊
He said, Dear brothers,
有火炼的试验临到你们
that there is a testing of fire that may come to you.
不要以为奇怪
Now do not find it strange that this is happening to you.
不要说怎么会有这样的事情发生
Do not say that such a thing happened to me.
这样的事情天天都在发生
Yes, every day these things do happen to people.
基督徒你要预备苦难的来到
So Christians, let us be prepared that sufferings may come to us anytime.
是的有的时候苦难是来自于你最亲近的人
It is true that sometimes suffering strikes someone that is very close to us.
你关系最好的人给你苦难
Maybe the person that gives you the greatest suffering is from someone that you love.
彼得说不要惊奇
Even so, Peter says, do not be surprised.
随时预备
We must be prepared anytime.
所以下一次当苦难来的时候
So the next time when sufferings do strike us,
你可以对他讲我在等你了
You may even say, here you are, I'm ready for you.
我预备好了
That I am prepared.
这是真实的弟兄姐妹
This is something that we must embrace.
只是感谢上帝他没有来得更早
But thanks be to God, sometimes they do not come as soon as we thought.
当我们读这一段经文的时候呢
But when we go back to this passage again,
保罗用了不同的名词来形容他所遭受的患难。
Now, Paul used a lot of terms to describe the sufferings that he had faced.
有患难，有苦楚，有必死的，有活命的指望都绝了。
He talked about hardships, he talked about pressure, he talked about even the sentence of death.
我们看到这些都是保罗实际的经历。
These are true events that Paul himself had faced with his own flesh.
那我们要知道保罗这样写不是要高举自己为主受苦多么的伟大
Now know that these terms that Paul used is not to elevate himself to show how great he was
而是他要让自己成为一个标本
But rather he wants himself to be like an example
来教导信徒如何胜过苦难的危机
Using his example to teach believers how we can overcome sufferings.
所以你看到保罗他虽然在写苦难但是呢他却带着积极向上的盼望。
But look at Paul, even when he was writing about sufferings, he wrote it in a positive yet optimistic way.
所以第三节他说愿颂赞归于我们的主耶稣基督的父神就是发慈悲的父。
You can see this in verse 3 because Paul started by saying,Praise be to God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and God of all comfort.
保罗是一个很会赞美的传道人啊。
Now, Paul was a preacher who loved to exhort and praise God.
所以他教导我们如何胜过苦难的危机。
Therefore, now he is teaching us how can we overcome sufferings.
不单单要承认苦难是真实存在和无法解释的。
Not only do we acknowledge the existence of suffering, not only do we acknowledge that suffering provides no answer,
不只是要预备苦难随时会来到
And not just that, we must prepare ourselves that suffering may come anytime.
而且很重要的就是当苦难真的来到的时候
And most important of all, when sufferings do arrive.
你在苦难当中应当颂赞
That in our trials, we must still continue to praise.
用颂赞代替悲伤
Using praising God to replace our groanings
用赞美取代埋怨
Using worship to replace our pain
我们看保罗他不单单的是这样讲他也是这样做的
We see that Paul did not just utter these words or write these words He himself lived such a life
当他和希拉被关在监牢里面的时候
Remember when Paul and Silas they were in prison
他们在那里做什么
Do you know what were they doing then?
埋怨上帝吗
Did they groan against God?
主啊我们听到你在给我们马其顿的呼声我们就来了
Did they groan by saying God we have heard your call at Macedonia and here we are
你为什么把我们放在监牢的里面
Why do you put us in a jail instead?
他们没有这样讲
This is not what they were grumbling
他们仍然大声地赞美神
But in a great voice they sang the praises of God
以至于地的根基都震动了
Such that the foundations of the world were shaken
是的，弟兄姐妹，我不知道今天的你来到一个怎样的苦境。
My beloved brethren, I do not know what suffering has happened to you right now.
有的人长期的失业。
Some of us have gone through long periods of trials.
有的人长期的病痛。
Some people have gone through long periods of sickness.
有的人家中有残障的孩子。
Some people may have children who are crippled or sick.
有的人一下子进入了一个孤单的环境。
And some people may have suddenly gone to a stage where everybody left them.
各种不顺利的情况下。
And under such great tribulation,
我问你，你会怎么样？
Can I ask you, what is your response?
有人埋怨上帝。
Some first response is a grumble against God.
有人开始怀疑，真的有神吗？
Some responses were, is there really God in my life?
有的人灰心绝望，神啊，你真的爱我吗？
And some may fall into despair and question, God, do you really love me?
有的人忧郁致死了。
And some may even fall into depression and to die.
但是我们看保罗，他说：“愿颂赞归于我们的主耶稣基督的父神。”
But yet God says, "Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and comfort."
赞美主吧。
He praised God instead.
大卫说：“我要时时称颂耶和华。”
So David says, "I will praise the Lord in all times."
赞美他的话必常在我的口中。
For the words of praise must always remain on my lips.
谦卑的人听见就要喜乐。
And the humble who listen, they will rejoice.
这个谦卑在原文的意思就是痛苦的人。
And humility in the original meaning, it is actually those who suffer.
是的，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，你要如何胜过苦难的危机？
So dear brothers and sisters, how can we overcome sufferings when they come to us?
怎么样从苦境当中转回呢？
Now how to turn back when we suffer?
不要停止聚会。
Let us not give up meeting each other.
不要停止敬拜。
Let us not give up worshiping.
不要停止颂赞。
Let us not give in praising God.
回到上帝的面前。
We must turn back to God.
你会发现我们基督教有一个特点。
You will discover that Christianity has this special characteristic.
不论什么聚会，我们都唱诗，都赞美。
No matter what meeting we might meet, we will always sing praises to God.
我们在主日礼拜唱，查经聚会也唱。
On our Sunday worship, on our Bible studies, we do that.
我们在婚礼唱诗，我们在丧礼也唱诗。
In weddings, we sing praises to God, even in funerals.
这些诗歌你在丰富快乐的时候你歌唱。
These hymns when we sing, whether we are rich or poor, we sing.
你在贫穷艰难的时候你一样唱。
In difficulty, in happiness, we still sing.
我们看到圣经说他使人在夜间歌唱。
For the scripture tells us that God allows a singing through the night.
是的，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，多多的唱诗吧。
Indeed.Let us sing praises to God.
趁着你记忆力还好的时候，背一些的诗歌在你的脑子的里面。
While we still can remember things, remember a few hymns that we can sing.
当你在苦境的时候，你可以颂赞神。
So that in our most darkest periods of our time, we can still choose to sing praises to God.
特别是我们有一些古老的圣诗。
Especially we have a lot of traditional hymns.
这些都是神在圣徒生命中的作为。
These were great compositions by the great spiritual giants that God has moved them to write.
多多的唱这些有生命力量的诗歌。
Sing more of these great traditional hymns.
而不是只是挑一些简单的、流行的这样的歌曲来唱。
Or not just choose those simple pop Christian music to sing every day.
如何胜过苦难的危机？
So how can we overcome sufferings?
当颂赞，当赞美。
We must praise, we must sing.
不要用怀疑和埋怨来取代赞美。
Do not use grumblings and doubts to replace our worship.
那样你只会进入一个恶性的循环的里面。
Then the more you do that, the more you enter into a vicious cycle.
而如何得胜苦难的危机？
And how can we overcome sufferings?
第三，保罗在这里教导我们说，圣灵动工，你会从被动转为主动。
And thirdly, Paul mentioned that the Spirit will help us from what we being passive were now actively living for God.
我们刚才讲过，保罗在这一段的经文当中呢，他并没有试图解释苦难的原因。
Now, earlier on, I already mentioned that when Paul talked about suffering in this passage, he did not explain why they were suffering.
你发现他更多的提到的是什么呢？
All the more, Paul wrote more on
上帝的安慰。
That is the comforts of God.
有十次之多。
There are 10 times.
中文的安慰呢，多多少少都给人一种好像感觉挺消极的哈。
Now the Chinese word 安慰 or comfort, it seems to have some negative connotations.
好像你得不了一等奖，得不了二等奖，你连三等奖也得不到。
Now to the Chinese term 安慰 or comfort, it means that if you cannot get top prize or second prize,
三等奖也没有啊。
Or not even the third prize.
那么最后给你一个什么？
Then what will they give you?
安慰奖咯
Maybe consolation prize.
所以安慰奖是人人都有的。
So the Chinese comfort is like a console to everyone.
所以这个安慰给人听起来好像是很消极的，可怜，在可怜我，给我一个安慰奖。
So to the Chinese term 安慰 or comfort, it seems to sound that it is something that I do not receive what is good, so I receive what is a less good.
但是在希腊文的里面，这个安慰呢，不是消极的，是很积极的。
But the Greek term of comfort, it is not passive, it is active.
是加力量给你，可以使你被提升起来的。
It means to add strength upon you that you may arise.
所以圣灵又被称为训慰师。
So therefore, the Spirit is also called the Counselor.
就是那一位安慰者。
That is the great comforter.
所以从上帝来的安慰。
So therefore, he says the comfort that comes from God.
不是同情你，不是可怜你。
God is not just taking pity on you. It is not because he despises you.
而是让你得着力量，奋发起来的力量。
But the comfort that God gives you is strength upon you that you may arise.
所以我们看到安慰又被称为圣灵的工作。
So therefore, comfort is also a work of the Holy Spirit.
所以当你在苦难当中的时候
So remember, when you are suffering,
圣灵动工使我们从被动转为主动。
The Holy Spirit, when he comforts us, it will draw us from passivity to livingly active for God.
人在苦难当中都是被动的。
A lot of times when we suffer, we lay back, we are passive, we do not want to do anything.
为什么？
Why?
因为没有人主动的会选择受苦。
Because no one will actively seek troubles.
所以我们什么都喜欢吃，就是不要吃苦。
So we like to eat anything, we do not like to eat troubles.
圣经也说啊，说智慧人见祸藏躲。
And a lot of times, Proverbs also mention that the wise will escape or run away from troubles.
愚昧人才会前往受害的。
Only the fools will head towards danger.
所以我们人性的里面很自然的我们会躲避苦难。
So naturally, we are made to run away from dangers.
但是我们看当圣灵动工的时候我们在苦难当中经历上帝的安慰。
But if the Holy Spirit were to work in us, the comfort that God gave us,
所以你可以把它从被动转为主动。
Will strengthen us from just mere passivity to livingly actively for God.
这是我们常常说的二里路的精神。
So this is often we say to go the extra mile.
所以有人强逼你走一里路吗？
So some people may compel you to go a mile with him.
那你就跟他走二里路。
Then go another extra mile then.
什么意思呢？
You know what that means?
这第二里路是我怎么样主动陪你走的。
The extra mile means this is not what I'm forced to.I choose to do so.
你就从被动转为主动了。
So now from passivity, you become actively making choices.
你说你这不是傻瓜、自我欺骗的阿 Q 精神吗？
You may say, preacher, you are just being foolish to just self-consoling yourself.
不是的。
It is not true.
而是我们经过思想之后，我们自己的选择。
But when we consider our options, we choose to live this way.
我们从被动转为主动。
From living just passively, we choose to live actively for God.
如何胜过苦难的危机？
So today, how can we overcome sufferings?
让圣灵动工，从被动转为主动。
Let the Holy Spirit work His comfort in us to strengthen us, that we may arise to live actively for God.
而你在态度上的转变，就是你在受苦当中仍然能够喜乐。
It also means by doing this.Your attitude of just being in despair is now changed to hopefulness.
你的眼睛，属灵的眼睛会被打开。
Your spiritual eyes will enlighten.
你会看到苦难的意义。
You will suddenly see why you are suffering.
基督徒不是白白受苦的。
We know that Christians do not suffer in vain.
我在青岛黄岛服事的教会呢。
When I was serving in 青岛 in this 黄岛 church.
是我从金莲毕业之后。
So after I graduated from 金莲。
回去和爸爸还有妹妹啊一起在建立的。
So I returned back to this church where my sister and my dad, we established this church together.
到今年7月20号是15年了。
So this July 20th, it will be our 15th anniversary.
那从开始之后呢，每一次有人数增加的时候，我们就搬家。
So from the start, each time when we have increased in numbers in the church, we will move house.
最后一次我们搬到是一个部队。他所不用的旧的房子。
So the next time that we move, or the last time we move, it is a barracks, that the army has left it alone, so we use that place for our church.
因为它的租金很便宜。
Now because rental of that barracks is very cheap.
地理位置又好。
And the locality is very good.
我们在那里一租就是九年。
So we rented that place for our church for 9 years.
感谢上帝的恩典。
So we thank God for His grace.
教会人数越来越多。
The numbers of our church have increased greatly.
那我们也把这个房子呢装修了。
We have also renovated this place that we have.
又把旁边的屋子也租过来，当做儿童主日学。
Now we also rented a nearby building to be our junior or children's Sunday school.
但是突然在2016年的六月份。
But suddenly, in 2016 in June.
政府突然下令说，所有属于部队的这些叫我们叫军产啊，全部都要没收回来，不准再出租使用。
So the government suddenly gave a command that all military buildings must be taken back and no longer for rental.
那么刚刚花了好几万装修的，也不给你赔偿。
Now even you may have spent tens of thousands in renovations, we are not going to compensate for what you have done.
但是周围还有很多的商家。
But there were a lot of businesses around us.
他们损失也很惨重。
They also suffered great losses because of this.
所以大家要一起到北京去上访，讨回公道。
So a lot of us want to petition to Beijing to at least get some compensation.
那我们教会就开始祷告了。
And because of that, our church we started to pray.
我们说主啊，你改变政府的心啊。
We say God, please change the government's mind.
君王的心不是在你的手中，好像龙沟的水随意流转吗
？Didn't the book of Proverbs say that the hearts of kings are in your hands, running like a watercourse freely?
可是我们祷告了好几个月。
But we have prayed for many months.
没有什么改变。
The government still was very determined.
那我们就转我们就开始思想说，为什么上帝会让这一件事情发生呢
？So we change another way of thinking. Why would God allow such a thing to happen to us?
我们损失好几百啊，好几万嘞。
We are going to lose tens of thousands.
所以当我们在思想的时候
，So while we have a change of thinking.
我们发现教会我们在这里已经待了九年了。
We discover we have used this place for 9 years.
虽然有传福音
，even though there's evangelism，
可是渐渐的大家好像都在安于现状了。
But yet everyone seems to be in their very comfort zone already.
当我们教会建立的时候，上帝的带领是让我们建立一个安提阿式的拆船的教会。
Now when our church first started, we have a call to be like the Antioch church.To send out missionaries.
但是十五年过去，我们一个职堂都没有。
But 15 years have passed. We have no mission chapel at all.
仍然停留在这个地方。
We still remain in this place only.
有尽力的服事。
We are serving faithfully.
但是没有竭尽全力的去抢救灵魂。
But there is no rescue station to rescue the souls out there.
当我们在思想的时候。我们开始感谢神兴起这样的环境。
So when we consider our situation, we start to thank God for giving us such a situation.
开启我们的眼睛。
He enlightened our eyes.
刚好这个时候我听到牧师的《满江红》。
Then at that time, it was at that time I read about Reverend Teo's this《满江红》。
这是岳飞的一首诗啊，一首词，然后牧师改的。
So in English, it means Rivers of Red that is actually written by Reverend Teo.
举目向田观看。
It means when I look at the plains,
庄稼发白。
And I see the harvest is white.
要抢救灵魂收入天仓的时候到了。
It is an opportune time to rescue the souls of the harvest.
圣灵责备我们的心。
And the Spirit rebuke us.
我们怎么能够安于现状，仍然在这里迟迟不向前行呢？
How can we comfortably remain where we are and refuse to advance more?
所以接下去我们就开始祷告，寻找地方。
So the next time we pray for a new location instead.
是在2017年的6月份。
So in June 2017,
我们的教会租了一个地方，同时又买了一个地方。
So our church rented another place, at the same time we also purchased another place.
我买了一个690平方的一个写字楼。
So we purchased this building, office building.
一共是460万。
4.6 million 人民币。
没有银行贷款。
So we did not take any church loans, bank loans.
现在460万已经还清了。
But yet this 4.6 million has been fully paid off.
只是还有借弟兄姐妹的100多万。
But we still have one million plus that we loan from brothers and sisters.
然后新堂呢，七月份装修好了就可以使用。
And this new church that we have purchased,in July, we can use it immediately.
而更奇妙的是周间，我们周边有两间的教会。
So amazingly, we have two churches next to us.
一个是500多人的教会。
One is a church that has 500 members.
那里有信徒，但是没有传道人。
Now over there, there are members, but no pastors.
而另外一个是一个很大的一个公司。
So another place is a big office.
他的老板是基督徒。
And the boss is a Christian.
所以请我们过去牧养。
So they actually invite us to pastor there.
目前在他们的公司的里面，我们只是有团契。
So right now at his office, we have a small fellowship.
因为他们是生产芯片的一个公司。
Now because they are a company that produce chips.
所以政府给他们很大的一个就是补助哈。帮助他们盖教堂。
So therefore, the government gave them a great subsidy that they can build a building there.
弟兄姐妹，我们已经有四间礼拜堂了。
So and when I say this here, I can say that we have four churches now.
是的，当我们眼睛只看到我们失去的。
So it is true. A lot of times when we only see what we have lost.
那我们就在那个地方被动的吃苦啊。
We start to become passive. We start not to do anything and just to suffer.
但是我们看到当圣灵动工的时候，
But if the Holy Spirit work his work in you,
他可以开启你的眼睛，
The Holy Spirit can open your eyes,
你从被动转为主动，
To prepare from being just passive to proactively living, serving for God.
基督徒的受苦不是白白的。
Let us know that the suffering of Christians will never be in vain.
现在在中国的一些的地方，
Now in many places in China,
比较强制性的不允许孩子还有党员大学生进礼拜堂。
So there are a lot of things which is a no-no for the Chinese government is that university students, children and so on are not allowed to go to churches.
在工作的地方他要让你签一个没有信仰的承诺书。
And when you work or you're employed, you must write a memo to say that you have no religion.
这些我们可以说，哎呀，逼迫来到了吗？
We might even say, has persecution arrived in China?
是的，弟兄姐妹，未来的路不会更好走。
Now, let us know, dear brothers and sisters, the road ahead of us Christians will be even worse.
但我想神许可的环境正是神在做筛选的工作。
But all times when God permits a situation, it is a time that God will do a great work.
过去的日子，中国的教会受很多的灵恩派、成功神学的影响。
In the past, the Chinese churches in China are assailed by a lot of prosperity gospel messengers and charismatic movement.
很多的人进入教会，但是生命当中却没有尊主为大。
A lot of the Chinese people, they may enter into churches, but their hearts are far from God.
仍然以自我为中心，缺少为信仰。
And often they sacrifice for no one but only themselves, and the worship is not for God.
而跟随耶稣只是为吃饼得饱。
And these people, when they follow Jesus, it's only that the bread is available for them.
而当苦难来到的时候，
But yet when sufferings come,
信心的真假就显明出来了。
A lot of times, who are true believers will be withered away.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，
So dear brothers and sisters,
神许可一些的环境艰难临到我们。
When God allows arduous times, hard times to come to us,
让我们不要被动的受苦。
Let us not passively just let sufferings come to us,
而是主动的来寻求上帝在其中的美意。
But proactively seek God's goodwill in these situations,
得着安慰和力量。
To receive comfort, to receive strength.
在接下去保罗继续的来教导我们。
And Paul continues to teach us,
他要怎样胜过苦难的危机呢？
How can he overcome sufferings?
就是要祷告。
He needs to pray.
是的，弟兄姐妹，我们要相信祷告。
Yes, we must believe in prayer.
你不祷告怎么知道你要靠上帝呢？
If we do not pray, how can we know that we need to trust God?
所以保罗说我要靠基督多得安慰。
So Paul says that we must rely on Christ to be comforted.
保罗说我不是靠自己，只是靠叫死人复活的神。
Now Paul says we do not rely on ourselves but on God who raises the dead.
弟兄姐妹
Brothers,
一定要祷告。
We have to pray.
而最后如何胜过苦难的危机呢？
And finally, when we overcome sufferings,
你要学会从永恒的角度看待今生。
We must learn to look at the present times from the perspective of eternity.
第九节保罗说叫我们不靠自己，只靠叫死人复活的神。
Because verse 9 Paul says we might not rely on ourselves but on God who raises the dead.
他曾救我们脱离那极大的死亡。
Verse 10 He has delivered us from such a deadly peril.
现在仍然救我们。
And he will deliver us.
并指望他将来还要救我们。
On him we have set a hope that he will continue to deliver us.
所以这里讲到神在我们身上的工作是永恒性的。
Look at the works of God, Paul says, it is for eternity.
弟兄姐妹，今天我们在世界上只是一个过渡。
Brothers and sisters, we are just pilgrims in this world.
在这个过渡的时期，信徒受苦。
In such a transitionary period, sufferings may come to us Christians.
我们在这个世界上可能没有答案。
Maybe we have no answers why.
但你要有耐心。
But we must be patient.
在上帝那里有答案。
That in God we will have answers.
所以约伯说：“我从前风闻有你。”
So Job once says, "Before I heard about you."
如今我亲眼看见你。
But now I will see you.
我知道我的救赎者活着。
Face to face, for I know my Redeemer lives.
末了必站在地上。
On the last day, he will stand on this earth.
我自己要见他，亲眼见他。
I will see him face to face with my own flesh.
我们要问自己，弟兄姐妹。
We need to ask brothers and sisters ourselves.
你预备好迎接你的神吗？
Are we prepared to meet our God?
一切的答案在上帝那里。
All answers are in God.
神借着这一切的环境，
A lot of times God used what we have gone through
来陶造我们，
To mold us，
洁净我们，
To cleanse us，
试炼我们，
To refine us，
提升我们，
And to grow us，
使我们的生命更加的成熟，
So that our lives may be more matured，
而且我们不是走向灭亡的地狱，
Know that we are not walking towards condemnation，
而是进入美好的天家。
But we are going towards heavenly words.
弟兄姐妹，
so brothers and sisters,
基督徒受苦，
Christians who suffer.
但是我们有天堂的盼望。
But we have the hope of heaven.
世界上的人受苦，
When people in this world suffer,
他们没有盼望。
They are in despair.
今天有的时候神许可苦难临到我们。
When God allows sufferings to happen to us,
就是要让你的眼睛离开这个暂时的世界。
So that our lives will depart from things of the world that is just for a while.
仰望天家吧。
Rather fix our eyes heavenwards.
因为我们常常忘记上面的事。
Because we often forget the things of above.
我们试图在地上留下永远。
We thought that we're going to live forever in this world.
没有受苦。
So that there's no suffering.
你不会仰望天家。
With no suffering, we do not know heavenwards.
记得。
Remember.
在那边。
Over there.
在那边。
Over there.
与主同在，好得无比。
That it is how wonderful to be with God over there.
每一次苦难的来到，更增加我们对永恒的盼望。
Every time when suffering comes to us, we have a greater hope of eternity.
这不是消极厌世。
This is not just being very passively waiting.
这是保罗所说的。
This is what Paul tells us.
在地上至暂至轻的苦楚，我要成就极重无比永远的荣耀。
For Paul once said that what we have gone through, these light and momentary troubles, will accomplish for us what is eternal and glorious ahead.
弟兄姐妹，
So brothers and sisters,
我们的主是复活得胜的主。
Let us know our Lord is a Savior who has gained victory over death.
他的恩典 够你我用的。
And His grace is sufficient for you and I.
苦难是真实存在的。
Sufferings do exist.
是没有答案的。
They have no answer.
随时随在，可能都发生在你我的生活当中。
Can happen to us in our everyday life anytime.
如何得胜苦难的危机？
But how can we overcome?
把自己交给这位复活的主吧。
Let us entrust our lives to this God who has risen from the dead.
主恩的滋味。
Taste and see that the Lord is good. 便知道
他是美善。
And know that His will is good.
苦难来到的时候，
When sufferings come,
让我们对主说，
Let us say to the Lord,
主啊，你的带领没有差错。
Oh God, you will lead us no wrong.
虽然我不明白，
Even though I may not understand why now,
但求你给我力量。
But may you add strength to me.
让我知道你有美意。
Let us know that you have a good will for me.
让我信靠你。
That I will trust you.
用颂赞取代埋怨。
And I will use my praises to overcome my groans.
用圣灵的安慰使被动成为主动。
I will use the comfort of the Spirit to draw me from passivity to actively.
帮助我相信祷告。
Oh God, help me to believe that I can pray.
帮助我从永恒的角度来看待今生。
And to look at my present time in the perspective of what is to come.
让我时刻预备朝见我的上帝。
So that anytime, even today, I will prepare to meet my God.
我们一起来低头祷告。
Let us pray.